Hi, I'm Mark Schultz with Ohio State University Extension. Standing in one of our alfalfa fields at the Western Agricultural Research Center in West Central Ohio. Today I want to talk with you a little bit about potato leafhopper damage in alfalfa. This insect pest is consistently the most damaging pest of alfalfa in the Midwestern states. It usually arrives in our alfalfa fields at the end of the first growth cycle in May. But it doesn't reach damaging levels until June, July, and even into mid-August. Once it starts to multiply, we get overlapping generations and the populations can build very rapidly. The insect is very small. It's about an eighth of an inch long. The adult has wings. It's lime green in color and wedge-shaped. The immature nymph stage is even smaller. Also lime green in color, wedge-shaped as well, but it does not have wings. It has a very characteristic sideways or diagonal movement when it's disturbed. The feeding can eventually result in visual damage, as shown in this picture, which we call hopper burn. And that is at the very tip of the leaflet, you'll see this yellowing in a V-shaped pattern, kind of a triangular pattern at the tip of the leaflet. This can be yellowing, it can be reddish in color, sometimes even purple, depending on the conditions. Once you see this damage, you've lost yield, you've lost some yield, and quality, primarily in relation to lower crude protein content. What we want to avoid is seeing this damage and preventing it ahead of time. And I'll talk about how to scout in another video and check for if the populations are going to build to damaging levels. The control at the early growth stages, really the only control is insecticide treatment. Another option closer to harvest would be an early harvest and then checking the regrowth. Another option is use of resistant varieties, and I will show that in another video as well. All those are options for control of this pest, but it does need to be checked each June and July and into August in alfalfa in the Midwest. Thank you for listening. This is Mark Schultz with Ohio State University Extension.